Hello, welcome to the self-learning podcast by Dr. Sushma Singh. Let us start discussion on Unit 4, Rural Urban Continuum. The world can be broadly divided into two types of human settlements, rural and urban. A variety of conceptual approaches has been applied to determine the essential social characteristics and dynamism of urban industrialism. These approaches include the formulation of typologies and the presentation of evolutionary frameworks, approaches that are often related. The detailing of social complexity is a key feature of analysis and is dealt with in several major ways. Another important methodological problem is the separation, conceptually and if possible empirically, of the social effects of urbanism and industrialism. Now let us move to the next point, approaches to the study of urban phenomena. There are three major approaches for the analysis of urban phenomena. These are, first, trait complex approach. In this approach, empirical attributes, generally quantitative traits, are taken for analyzing differences like occupation, size, density, homogeneity, and environment, etc. The second type is the ideal type. There are two types of ideal type approaches, that is non-polar and polar. The first one is non-polar. The concept of an ideal type has been applied to communities as it has been applied to the study of other social phenomena. This conceptual device is a constructed proposition which designates the hypothetical characteristics of a pure or ideal type. As used in this sense, the terms pure or ideal have nothing to do with the subjective evaluations of phenomena being studied. The technique of ideal type analysis is a form of comparative method. Actual empirical instances are compared with the ideal type to see how closely they approximate the ideal type. This type of approach is known as non-polar ideal type approach. The second one is polar or rural urban continuum approach. This is also known as the polar ideal type analysis, which compares empirical cases with the two logical extremes. It generally assumes that there is continuum between the two polar types along which empirical cases order themselves. Continuum is an uninterrupted series of gradual changes in the magnitude of a given characteristic, forming a linear increase or decrease through a series of gradual degrees. Rural and urban communities cannot be placed in watertight compartments. There is continuity between the two. As a community moves from the folk to the urban end of the continuum, there occurs shifts from cultural intimacy and organization to disorganization. collective or community orientation to individualization and the sacred to the secular. Redfield's speculations about what he saw as the significant changes from the folk to urban end of the continuum are based on studies conducted in the Yucatan during the early 1930s in the city of Merida, the town of Destas. The Maya peasant village of Chancom and the tribal hamlet of Tusik. Now let us move to the next point, explanation. Briefly stated, Redfield's scheme defines an ideal type, the folk society, which is the polar opposite of urban society. The ideal type is a mental construct, and no known society precisely corresponds to it. It is created only because through it we may hope to understand reality. Its function is to suggest aspects of real societies which deserve study, and especially to suggest hypotheses as to what, under certain defined conditions, may be generally true about society. The folk society has the following characteristics. It is small, isolated, non-literate and homogeneous, with a strong sense of group solidarity. The way of living are conventionalized into that coherent system which we call a culture. Behavior is traditional, spontaneous, uncritical and personal. There is no legislation or habit of experiment and reflection for intellectual ends. Kinship, its relationship and institutions are the type categories of experience, and the family group is the unit of action. The sacred prevails over the secular. The economy is one of the status rather than of the market. Now let us wind up the session and take rest. Thank you very much for engaging yourself with the self-learning podcast.